If you're looking to lose weight and burn fat, and if you've seen fitness influencers and online health people who are just in great shape with six-pack abs and they're jumping in and out of a cold plunge in their backyard, and you're wondering if cold water immersion, maybe it's the missing link on your fitness journey, this video is for you. Here's what we'll talk about. Number one, why brown adipose tissue, brown fat, why the thermogenic fat burning benefits are probably exaggerated and it probably is not the secret you're looking for. Number two, we'll talk about why the real benefits of cold water immersion, the more interesting benefits, are psychological. And number three, we'll talk about the importance of investing your limited time and money when it comes to health and fitness wisely. My name is Lucas. I'm a yoga teacher. I'm a nutritional coach. I'm a huge fan of cold water immersion. Some of my earliest memories in childhood are me and my older brother in northern Wisconsin in the winter on frozen lakes. Then we'd break through the ice and jump in. That psychological cleanse, that rush of feeling, we'll talk about a little later in the video, has kept me coming back to cold water again and again whenever I get a chance. Cold ocean, mountain streams, cold plunges at spas, any and all of the above, I'm a huge fan. This video is not meant to discourage you from cold water immersion, but simply to clarify how it works and where you should put your focus. The confusion really comes down to something called brown adipose tissue. It's abbreviated BAT, brown adipose tissue. It's a very interesting type of fat that's located right here on your back, for some people underneath their collarbones on the front, maybe even a little bit down into your chest. And there's very little of this brown fat, about 50 grams, so not much at all. What's interesting about this type of fat is that it's stimulated when you do full cold water immersion, especially up to your neck, meaning you start to create more of it. How much more? Well, maybe you go from 50 grams to 60, 75 grams, maybe 100 grams, still not very much. But why we get excited about brown adipose tissue is because it's highly metabolic. What does that mean? Well, it burns a lot of calories. It takes a lot of energy. In fact, brown adipose tissue can actually burn white adipose tissue, so normal body fat. This little blob of brown fat here can burn the white fat we want to get rid of. This all sounds amazing. We get in the cold water, we get more brown fat, we get more brown fat, we get less belly fat, we get six-pack abs. Wait a minute, does this really work? Wouldn't it be great if we had like some group of people we could look at to compare to see if this actually works? Oh wait, we do. They're called babies. Babies have tons of brown adipose tissue, relatively speaking, about the same as adults, so 50 grams, but they're much smaller. So relatively speaking, they have a thermogenic powerhouse on their back. It's designed to keep them warm in the cradle, and it works really well. But surely those babies then, since they have that metabolic chunk of brown adipose tissue on their back, they must be in a calorie deficit all the time. They must be lean and mean and 7%, six-pack abs. Not really. Babies are chubby. You know what happens when they get that deficit? They just tip the bottle up and drink a little bit more. But that's not a fair analogy. Babies are not adults. We're at a different point in our development. It'd be better if we compared an adult group who had normal brown adipose tissue with a group that had way more, much more, maybe double. Oh, we do. They're called Inuit people, and they live in northern Canada and Alaska and Greenland. They're exposed to cold temperatures their entire lives, and so some researchers theorized, hey, I bet these people have more brown adipose tissue. Did some research, 2013, and they discovered, yes, they do. In some cases, as much as double on average as someone like you or me. So surely Inuit people look like CrossFit athletes with six-pack abs and 7% body fat. Nope, not really. They struggle with the same metabolic disease and obesity, pretty similar rates to most other developed countries in the world. Why? Because weight loss is not as simple as creating a calorie deficit. If it was, we could just go outside and keep walking around the building until we created a deficit. Pretty frustrating, but it's a pretty common story. In fact, this story repeats itself every year. This year, people are talking about brown adipose tissue. Last year, they were talking about the soleus push-up. You remember that one? Your soleus is one of your calf muscles, and researchers got very excited because if you pulsed lifting your heels up and down, for 4.5 hours every day, you were supposed to create a calorie deficit and fix your metabolism and all these wonderful benefits. And obviously, no one's ever done that ever in their life. 4.5 hours of calf raises is a ridiculous thing to suggest. But every year, there's something new. Before that, you were supposed to fidget with your pens to burn calories. And guess what? In case you didn't know, if you play chess for 2 hours, the mental focus required will also burn 200 calories. Surely chess players are jacked and ripped and thin and lean, and sometimes yes and sometimes no. The reality is weight loss is complicated. And while the law of thermodynamics holds true, meaning energy cannot be created or destroyed, what happens with a typical calorie deficit, whether that's the baby with a lot of brown fat or the Inuit person with a lot of brown fat or the me person with not so much brown fat, when we have a calorie deficit from chest, from soleus pushups, or from brown fat, we just eat a little bit more. The baby tips up the bottle, I take another spoonful. It's very, very easy to make up a calorie deficit. Your body is not stupid. Trying to outsmart your biology by creating a little deficit here and there, it doesn't work that way. Unfortunately, the same principles, the same complex relationship with food and exercise and stress and sleep, all of those things still apply. Hopefully, maybe someday there will be a breakthrough with brown adipose tissue, cold water immersion. That's not the thing. So what is the thing? Mental and emotional health. When you get in the cold water, your body freaks out. Your circulatory system contracts, it constricts, and the reactive response is actually to relax. It's really great for your circulation. From a mental health perspective, your body releases two of the four neurochemicals that are correlated with happiness, specifically endorphin and dopamine. And you also get a hit of noradrenaline, which gives you this rush. Your body switches into a fight or flight mode, so it's highly, highly arousing. The analogy I like to use is if you walk over to the fuse box in your house, pull everything down, and push everything back up. If you're watching this video, you've probably experienced this at some point. Maybe you love cold immersion, maybe you love cold showers, maybe you hate them, but you can't deny that feeling. It is like a total reset for your brain. And it's amazing. It's also well documented, well researched, and studied. Here's the thing. Should you, because of the mental health benefits, buy a cold water plunge for your backyard? I don't know. Probably not. If it costs $5,000, the answer is probably not, because most people find that those positive effects, if you do it every single day, they tend to diminish. The best way to get the biggest results is with irregular use. I like to think about it like Sunday brunch. Maybe you fill up the bathtub, throw some ice in, and jump in once a week. The reason that I think this is important is a lot of these cold plunges, they cost $5,000. And $5,000 is a lot of money. And if you're thinking about your health journey, a lot of money and a lot of time invested in something with kind of dubious results probably isn't the best choice. $5,000 can buy you and your family clean protein in a freezer for probably a year or more. $5,000 could help you set up a home gym that could last you a decade or more. $5,000 could help you to hire a personal trainer or a chef, probably for a year or maybe even a couple of years. That could really move the needle in terms of your health and wellness. And if you initially came to cold immersion because of fat loss, you're probably gonna have better metabolic benefits from some of those. However, if you have $5,000 laying around and you'd like to buy one of these expensive cold plunges, please invite me over. I'll be the first person to jump in. Just make sure you're using it with eyes wide open, knowing that this is not the fat burning machine that has been marketed to you as. If you enjoy this video, hit subscribe down below. I publish science-based yoga videos once a week. You can find my teaching calendar at yogabody.com. I'll drop a PDF link down below with some of the research and references that I mentioned in the video here. And lastly, if you have questions or comments, love to hear from you down below. Thanks for watching. I'll see you in the next video.